The question will be, is the removal of the president of the Senate, is it a constitutional matter, or is it a matter that should be guided by the rules of the Senate?
Both ways. For me, the rules or the order of Senate has due process in convening the Senate and carrying on activity in terms of the other people and what have you. Then the Constitution provides, of course, for a president of the Senate. The political argument is, should we allow a situation where the president of the Senate does not enjoy the majority of Senate? You know, in other societies, take Britain for instance, the Queen will just invite whoever she thinks can command the majority of the legislators to form a government. We're not that refined, I'm sorry to say. We are still very backward in the way we are running our affairs. When people start seeing some semblance of propriety, or call it morality, then the legislature will go places. For now, we have people who just think of their interests, like Kingsley said, they are interested in themselves, not in the burning issues of the moment. Good governance, because that's what we should be interested in.
Mr. Mogalo, you are going for Mr. Brower for the first seat in the country, the seat of the president.
Yes.
And one would have thought that if having done your own assessment and then seeing the political turbulence that we're in right now, you would have feared. But unfortunately, you're not afraid of that. But the question now is that if the Constitution, as Prof rightly says, is one that is illegitimate, what can you do to ensure that the Constitution plays a major role in curtailing some of this political turbulence that we're experiencing?
See, I'm a principled person. And I'm a pragmatic person. The Constitution is not a people's constitution, the constitution we have now. But there is nothing we can do about it other than either going through a process of amending the Constitution as provided in the Constitution that we have today, or, I believe, more fundamentally, electing a leadership in Nigeria that has a vision for the country. And part of that vision is a constitutional restructuring of the Nigerian Federation. I have that vision. That requires a constitutional amendment, a people's constitution that also addresses the national question. How do we live together as a people? How do we govern ourselves to become a civilized country? Do you understand? What is the basis of our Nigerianness? Is it the fact that I am Yoruba or Hausa or Igbo? Or is it the fact that I am a citizen of Nigeria, the political identity of citizenship? How do we develop a country that can make progress for all of us and take us into the 21st century? That's why I'm running for president, because I have a world view. The challenge I see now is a challenge to the people of Nigeria to wake up and politically, democratically, at the ballot box, overthrow these clowns. Enough is enough. That's the issue. How can we be sitting down here analyzing the political antics of self-serving politicians instead of holding them to account for whether or not they have improved our lives? Nigerians are getting poorer and poorer and poorer. That's the issue. But that's not the issue for these guys. So I don't want to waste my time analyzing who should be where. I am spending my time educating our people on why we need to rise up and execute a political revolution at the ballot box in 2019 and overthrow these incompetent and visionless politicians
We will
and
vote
take charge
out.
of our lives. Yes, sorry, vote out, overthrow at the ballot box. That means vote out. That's what I mean. That I keep insisting on the democratic nature of the revolution that we're calling for. That's what it is, not bloody. No.
So 91 political parties. Is
That's
that
right.
the way to go?
I personally don't think so, but who am I to question the wisdom of the laws? The laws allow it for now, but that's part of what we're talking about. When you pretend to be a democracy, when in fact you're not, You're registering all kinds of political parties, 100 political parties.
Is it against the law?
It's not against the law, but that's what I'm trying to say. The point I'm trying to make is this. How serious, how transparent is our electoral process? Many people want to register to vote today, but they cannot. You go to voting, you go to registration centers, lines are long. People get tired of waiting and they go away. We can't even organize simple electoral processes, and we're registering hundreds of parties. We always place emphasis on the wrong things. We want to pretend we're being democratic by allowing every Tom, Dick, and Harry to register a party. But we're not focusing on how to register Nigerian citizens, to empower them to participate, let them have a voice in democracy. INEC stopped the registration on August 17. I went to INEC alongside, together with Charlie Boy Oputa and Omoyele Sowore, and we demanded that the registration be extended. And we gave good reasons. In 2015 elections, registration stopped in December 2014. Why should registration stop now in August? Well, we've just heard they've extended it by 2 weeks. Okay, that's an extension. So I would say that Nigerians should move massively to register. But is INEC ready to absorb the millions of people who may want to register? So the question of whether our democracy is actually functioning, whether our votes matter, is what should concern us, not pretending to be running a circles of hundreds of parties.
Yeah, Mr. Mogolo, concerning the political parties, the newly registered one especially,
yes,
some believe that having more political parties takes governance to the grassroots. Do you share in that belief?
No, I don't share that view. I share the view that what takes governance to the grassroots, or what will take governance to the grassroots in this country, is a constitutional restructuring of Nigeria, to return Nigeria to a proper federation, so that we devolve powers and accountability. That is what will bring governance down to the grassroots. It's not, you know, pseudo-democracy that we are trying to run. We need to bring, you know, governance down to the people. The current structure of Nigeria doesn't allow that. Everything is in Abuja, and so becoming president is do or die. But when we restructure...
Those are the people you're going to face. It's do or die for them.
Well, you know, that's fine. But you see, no retreat, no surrender. I don't believe in surrendering to problems. I believe in overcoming challenges. That's the worldview I have. That's the worldview that can take Nigeria into the 21st century. A lot of powerful countries in the world today, we are once in the situation in which Nigeria is today. But effort of will, application of will, mobilization of the people, as we are trying to do now, to say to people, look, you don't have to be stuck with APC and PDP. There is an alternative. There are alternatives.
All right.
Look at them.
We'll talk about that, and then also take a look at the security of it all when we come back in a moment. Stay with us.